Why don't we begin? Senator, would you like to begin?
Sure. I'd like to welcome everyone to this Joint Budget Conference Committee on Economic Development. I am privileged, I should say, to co-chair this with Assemblyman Schimminger. This table represents an area which is of vital importance to every citizen of this state from one end to the other. And we will discuss those areas in which we have agreement and those in which we do not. Let me first, Assemblyman, introduce the members of the Senate on this committee. To my right, Senator Griffo, Senator Bonasek, Senator Akshar, Senator O'Mara, Senator Perkins, and Senator Kennedy.
Thank you very much, Senator Lanza. Already I can tell that this is the beginning of a warm and lasting friendship that you and I will have.
We have time.
Play it again, please. This is, of course, the Joint Budget Subcommittee on Economic Development, and as Senator Lanza has said, there's nothing more important in our state than jobs, 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 and economic development is all about encouraging job retention and job growth. We also have some very distinguished members of the New York State Assembly who serve as members of this Joint Budget Subcommittee on Economic Development. And with your indulgence, Senator, I would like to introduce them as well. We have Gary Pretlow, who chairs our Committee on Racing and Wagering. We have Fred Thiel, who chairs the Committee on Small Business. Eddie Russell from the North Country. And we have two alternates, one of whom is sitting up here, Angelo Santa Barbara, and also Ed Braunstein, who is right behind me. Okay? We have from the Assembly Minority, Mr. Mark Butler sitting at the very end, and also we have another member named Tedisco, I think you pronounce it. I don't see him here. So those are the members of the Assembly who are members of this group. Why don't you tell us a little, Senator, about what agencies will be covered by our table?
First, let me begin with an area of disagreement. It seems my alma mater, Monsignor Farrell High School, led by Coach Dunn, had an incredible run this year, which ended at the state championship game. They were defeated by Canisius. I think you know something about Canisius, so I just wanted to give them a shout out. Both those schools are doing a wonderful job. You did attend Canisius, didn't you?
I attended Canisius College.
Oh, all right.
Canisius College was founded in 1870 by German Jesuits. It continues to function and operate as a premier institution of higher education college at 2001 Main Street in Buffalo. There is also a high school, Canisius High School. There you go.
I just wanted to give a shout out to Coach Dunn and Monsignor Farrell High School.
Duly noted,
the
Senator.
Following duly agencies, noted. The following agencies are at our table and are considered open: Department of Economic Development, Urban Development Corporation, Empire State Development Corporation, and New York State Gaming Commission.
Do you have a recording secretary?
Yes, I will designate John Taroski as our recording secretary.
And I will recommend and appoint as our recording secretary Ms. Deborah Jenkins.
Why don't we move right to the areas of agreement?
Why don't you start?
I shall. Both houses identify agreements within the following areas. We accept funding for the following: Center of Advanced Technology, Industrial Technology Extension, SUNY Albany and RPI Focus Centers, High Technology Matching Grants, Gateway Information Centers at Binghamton and Beekmantown, and Research Development Science and Technology Law Center.
Excellent. Let me digress. You were talking about high school basketball.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, I was never much of a basketball player. But my high school that I did attend, not Canisius High School, but Cardinal O'Hara High School, the girls' basketball team has been over the past several years, a statewide championship-level team.
Congratulations.
Cardinal O'Hara High School, named for John Francis O'Hara, who had been a bishop in Buffalo, a cardinal in Philadelphia, and the president of Notre Dame.
We digress.
We do. Let's talk.
Did I mention Mount Vernon High School? Perennial champions of basketball?
Yes, they are. Great team.
I sit between two basketball greats on either side.
State champ girls basketball.
We accept.
It is March Madness.
Both houses. Both houses accept funding in the area of UDC and ESDC for the Clarkson-Trudeau Partnership, the Buffalo High-Tech Manufacturing Innovation Hub, the Brookhaven National Laboratory, the New York Power Electronics Manufacturing Consortium, the Urban and Community Development Program, the Entrepreneurial Assistance Program, and the retention of Western New York football. There are also some areas of Article 7 that should be mentioned.
Yes, Article 7, areas in which we agree. We accept the one-year extension of the Economic Development Fund, and we also accept extending UDC's loan powers for 1 year.
And we are blessed to have here on this committee the two chairs of the racing committees of each house, and that area is part of our
Public housing matters! Public housing matters! Public housing matters! Public housing matters! Public housing matters!
It does.
Building dollars now! Building dollars now! Building dollars now! Building dollars now! Building dollars now!
Is this the housing committee?
Building dollars now!
Oh, okay.
You're in the wrong place.
It's nice. As my friend John Kasich said the other day, it's nice to be someone who grew up in the 60s and 70s, and I did, so I've seen protests before. But your comments are really misplaced. This is not the meeting where housing is being discussed.
You want to go over there.
You want to go over there.
We're going to vote to approve budgets. We need you all to support $2.5 billion over the next 5 years, just as the governor is putting forward for an affordable housing plan. We need a plan for public housing.
It's nice to have you all here, but you're hurting your cause. You hurt your cause.
For NYCHA, New York City, people are dying of toxic mold because local and state governments have failed to put forward mold. Public housing matters.
We've heard you.
Public housing matters. Public housing matters.
He's the actor.
Public housing matters.
He's the actor.
Public housing matters. Public housing matters. Public housing matters. Public housing matters. Billions for NYCHA now. You all have the ability to put forward a budget that could save lives in NYCHA. We ask you all to do that. Thank you very much. Public housing matters. Public housing matters. Public housing matters. Public housing matters. Public housing matters.
You're going to do a Trump thing?
Maybe they didn't like our comments, Senator.
I don't think they enjoy the friendship. So we will.
They want more drama, more adversarialism.
So the idea.
They do.
Yeah.
They do. Out back.
Okay.
I'll hold the coats.
So the idea here with this Joint Budget Conference Committee is for the Assembly and the Senate to reconcile its differences in terms of the budget bill. We will do that without shouting at
indeed,
each other.
Indeed, yes. And it's nice to have people communicating in the wrong hearing room at the wrong time, but that's okay. I was about to say that in this Joint Budget Conference Committee, there are areas of agreement in the area of the New York State Gaming Commission. And the Assembly and Senate both have accepted the appropriations for the Gaming Commission that were proposed by the executive. And in addition, the Assembly and the Senate accept the budget proposals to adjust the timing of billing and payment of per diem costs paid to the Gaming Commission by licensed harnessed racing corporations for the cost of racing judges and starters. Extend the current vendor fee, 41%, paid to the Monticello Video Lottery Terminal Facility for 1 year. extend the current parimutuel tax rates and out-of-state simulcasting provisions for 1 year, and amend the Upstate New York Gaming and Economic Development Act of 2013 to clarify that host community payments are to be funded from revenue attributable to a specific licensed gaming facility in that host county and host municipality. Those are the areas of agreement in the area of gaming. Senator?
Chairman, if you don't mind, I'd like to see whether there are comments from members on this committee from the Senate side.
Sure.
Senator Bonasek?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I want to say that I'm always pleased to work with my partner, Assemblyman Gary Pretlow, who has moved the needle forward in helping the agricultural industry as well as the racing industry. Exciting things are happening in the state of New York as a result of the people's vote to authorize and permit commercial gaming in the state of New York. Four resorts are being built. We always refer to them as casinos, a lot of people do, but much of this is resorts with an investment of approximately $2.5 billion by private sector money, creating construction jobs, creating permanent jobs, and when they are up and running, they will enhance revenues for education. The other thing I'd like to mention is those counties that are adjacent to the county that landed the resort, the host county, they will all receive a piece of the action that is generated by casino gaming to help municipalities and property tax reduction. And as an adjunct to that, working with Assemblyman Pretlow, working on an online poker bill that may be coming down the pike, and with respect to fantasy sports, nothing is going to happen until the lawsuit with our Attorney General Eric Schneiderman plays out, or in the event there's a settlement, in the event that that is not resolved by a judicial decision, I will work with our Assemblyman Pretlow to try to move that needle forward. So thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman. Pretlow, I think, wanted to comment very briefly.
No, Mr. Chair, I want to concur with everything that my colleague, Mr. Bonasek, said. We do agree on many things. But if you notice, we're both wearing black suits, but he's
very
wearing
nice.
He's wearing a white tie, and I'm wearing a black tie.
Go so figure.
So it shows that there are some areas of disagreement that we have. the entire casino thing has come to fruition for the time being. I think there are some areas that we have to address, especially in involving the area around Tyree. There are a lot of other entities that are adversely affected by that casino being opened there. And that's something that we're going to have to discuss. Maybe we can get to the budget. We'll try to. If not, there will definitely be future legislation regarding that.
Thank you, Assemblyman Pretlow. I know everyone is wondering whether we have received table targets yet. Do you want to answer that, Senator, or shall I give the answer?
So we have not.
We have not.
And
darn. And despite the agreements that we have identified heretofore, I assure everyone that the conversations will be ongoing, right? And that the staffs will be working very, very, very hard, and we thank the staffs. We thank the staffs to resolve the open issues in economic development and the issues involving the State Gaming Commission.
With confidence that those conversations shall be fruitful. If there are no other comments, yes?
Mark Butler, ranking member.
A comment, just very briefly. Obviously, a large amount of our charge revolves around economic development programs, and quite correctly, they're based on job creation. But how that plays out is that our small business people, just by virtue of their identity, don't have access to a lot of assistance to the economic development programs that the state offers, and in fact, have a heavy burden in terms of the regulation, the potential for dramatic increases in the minimum wage. So I would urge my colleagues, as we look at these programs and move forward, if not as part of this budget, but in the very near future, to take into consideration the needs of small business people in New York State. Because I don't know what your experience is. My phone is being clogged by calls from small business people that say the direction the state is moving is making it daily more difficult for them to do business. And I think it's time that we need to pay a little bit more attention to that important segment of our economy.
Thank you, Mr. Butler. Small business always on our mind. Any other closing remarks or comments? With that, Senator, I think we should bring it to a close. We only had one set of disruptors here, so stay tuned.
Quit while we're ahead.
Quit while we're ahead. Thank you all very much.
To the strings of ebony and ivory.